Urban forestry is a big part of the city's overall environmental protection plan. Given the recent and continuing impact of the pine beetle epidemic, the city is taking steps to control other potentially dangerous pests, the first being the western spruce budworm.
Now, with spruce budworm, that is a pest that can occasionally kill trees, but usually the trees will recover from that attack. And so it's not something that you aren't going to see any visual damage from, though. You will see some deformity or some reshaping of the tree.
The budworm feeds primarily on Douglas fir, but will attack other trees like western larch, lodgepole pine, and of course spruce. But the city has already been very effective in controlling this insect.
Last year, 400 hectares in Kennecartwright Park were treated. It was treated with BTK, which is a naturally occurring bacteria that is selective to caterpillar-type pests. And there was great success with that, which I'm pleased to announce on that. And every location within the city that is being currently monitored, right now it shows low to medium levels of attack on those trees.
The second and potentially more dangerous bug is the Douglas fir tussock moth. Not only is it capable of decimating its namesake, it can also move on to ponderosa pine, western larch, and ornamental spruce. Here's what to look for.
The mature larvae are easy to recognize by the prominent tufts that you'll find on either end of the body. Larvae at all stages, they will feed, that's the caterpillar, the larva, will feed on new needles, and then they will move on to older needles, eventually stripping and killing the tree. So yes, Douglas fir tussock moth has the potential to cause great damage, unlike the spruce budworm that will just cause visual damage and eventually recover. With the tussock moth, it's quite likely that the tree will be lost.
Again, however, the city has an action plan in place.
We've been monitoring the tussock moth population using pheromone traps, and the results collected from that monitoring has determined that in partnership with the Ministry of Forests and Range, that there will be an aerial treatment on public and crown lands. That will occur in Juniper and at Eliza Road and Blackwell Road in Barnhartvale.
And when it comes to the most notorious bug of all, the mountain pine beetle, the news isn't all bad.
Yes, we can see a lot of destruction around us, but there's a lot of regeneration. For every tree that we have lost to pine beetle, there's significant numbers of naturally occurring juvenile trees out there to replace them. So we will see those coming up in the forest stands.
In the event you think you may have trees under attack from any of these insects, visit www.kamloops.ca/trees for links and more information, or contact a certified arborist or a forest health professional.